Welcome to all dear students. We are learn the rearrangement reaction. Earlier lecture we learn the number of rearrangement reaction related to the carbocation intermediates, and from last lecture we are going to learn the nitrene intermediate rearrangement reaction. We already studied the Hofmann rearrangement reaction. Now we are going to study the next rearrangement reaction, that is what? The Curtius rearrangement reactions. What is the Curtius rearrangement reaction? Here it is a thermal or photochemical rearrangement reaction. Thermal or photochemical rearrangement reaction of the acyl azide to a isocyanate was discovered by a Curtius, and it provide the means of degradation of the acid to a primary amine. Further, it get converted to what? Primary amine. Sorry, this is a primary amine. That means here, this is the reaction where the rearrangement or degradation of acid is converted to the primary amine by the formation of the what? Acyl azide into the isocyanate. Here the acyl azide are usually prepared either by the reaction of sodium azide with the reactive acylating agent or by a diazotization of acyl hydrazide. Let we learn some different reaction where we prepare the acyl azide. The first we learn, that is what? The acyl which on reacted with a chloro ethyl ester, or where this acid get converted to this compound by the removal of HCl. This O group directly bonded to this carbonyl, okay, and there is a formation of this compound. Then which is reacted with the sodium azide, then there is a formation of what? This acyl azide. There are the different way to prepare this acyl azide. This is the first way. Second, that is we also prepare the acyl azide from this compound, that is RC11O NH2. This is reacted with, this is the amide compound which is reacted with the HNO2. Then there is a formation of what? RCON3. Okay, this is also the another way to prepare what? The acyl azide. Another also way, there is a formation of acyl azide from diphenyl phosphoryl azide. That means whenever this acid, that is RCOOH, which is treated with this type of compound, that is called as a diphenyl phosphoryl azide, then it get converted to the acyl azide. This is the main reactive intermediate. This further converted to the isocyanate. Let me learn, start with the mechanism. Here this acid which is reacted with the chloroethanoate, on heating there is a formation of this compound by the removal of HCl. Then which is further reacted with the sodium azide, and by breaking of this bond there is a formation of RCON3. This is called as a acyl azide. This acyl azide further get converted to the isocyanide. Let me learn how it converted to the isocyanide. Here these R CO N, this is this N3 group, which is like this manner, N triple bond N plus. Okay, then what happened here? This negative charge is shifted to here. At the same time, this R group is rearranged like this manner. Then there is a formation of like this product, that is, this carbon is bonded to the oxygen, there is a carbon nitrogen bond, and here in the intermediate stage there is a formation of carbon nitrogen double bond. There is a partial in the intermediate stage, there is a formation of a bond between the carbon and the nitrogen, and at the same time there is a breaking of this bond, and that's why here there is a breaking, partial breaking of this bond between the N2. Okay, and here this R group is shifted to here, that means that this R group make a bond with this of nitrogen. We can see like this manner, there is a partial breaking and partial making of the bond. There is a partial breaking of CR bond and partial making of the RN bond. This is the intermediate stage, and then there is a product. This is like this C double bond O. There is a double bond with the carbon and nitrogen also, and here this R group is attached to here by the removing of the N2 group. This is the mechanism of preparation of this type of compound, that is called as the isocyanate compound. This is the isocyanate compound. Here in the Hofmann reaction also prepare the isocyanate compound, but what is the difference between that? Here in case of Curtius rearrangement reaction, this isocyanate is isolable. Okay, then that means what? Whenever this reaction which can be takes place, that is a RCON3, on heating there is a formation of isocyanate, that is R N double bond C double bond O. This is isolable. That's why no nucleophile is present over here, and that's why here from this isocyanate compound we can be prepared the number of different products. But in case of Hofmann reaction, this is present in Curtius reaction, and in a Hofmann reaction what happened here? This R C double bond O N Br, this get converted to, this is the nucleophile present over here, and that's why here what happened here, this there is a formation of this isocyanide which is not isolable, and that's why here in presence of OH minus or base, it directly get converted to the RNH2. That means what? In a Curtius reaction, which reagent here we are going to add? According to that, there is a formation of the different types of product. It is isolable. That's why here, by the attacking of any group, we can prepare the different types of the amides and the acids. Different compound here we prepared. But in case of Hofmann rearrangement, there is a presence of nucleophile. This isocyanide is not isolable, and which further reaction with the base, there is a formation of only the primary, there is a presence of only what? The primary amide. Formation of only primary amide. Okay, this is about the mechanism of the conversion of acid to the acylazide, and acylazide get converted to the isocyanate. Let me learn the reactions, some reactions of isocyanates. Whenever here this is reacted with a water molecule, then here this is the formation of like this compound, that is R NH C double bond O OH. Okay, how this prepare over here? This OH breaking of this bond, here this electron accepted by this nitrogen, and this hydrogen is which H plus is attached to this nitrogen and OH minus is attached to this carbon. There is a formation of this intermediate. And further on tautomerism, there is a formation of the product, that is what here this bond is shifted to here, and here this nitrogen accept this bond hydrogen, and there is a breaking of this bond. There is a formation of what? The R NH2 plus CO2 by further reaction with the water molecule. Next, here whenever ROH is attacked, ROH which is reacted with this compound, then same reaction which happened, this break like this manner, OR minus and H plus. Then this R O minus which is attacked to this carbonyl, and H plus attacked to this H plus attacked to this nitrogen. There is a formation of like this product, that is R NH C double bond O and OR. This is the another product here we form. If here the reagent is secondary amine, that is NHRR, then how will be the product? This is dissociated into N minus and H plus. This N minus which is attached to this carbon, and this H plus which is attached to this nitrogen, and there is a formation of like this product, that is R NH C double bond O, and here this N attached to this compound. Okay, that is, this is the secondary amide here we prepare, R NH CO N R dash. Next reagent here we used, that is the acid, that is R dash COOH. Then how it get dissociated? O minus and H plus, that is R COO minus which is attached to this carbonyl, and H plus is attached to this nitrogen. There is a formation of R NH C double bond O. This is O minus attached to here, and C double bond O. This is the product. That means this type of different product which can be prepared by using this isocyanate in a continuous rearrangement reaction, because these are isolable. But in Hofmann rearrangement reaction, there is a preparation of only primary amine, not the different types of the product. Okay, because in Hofmann rearrangement, this is a non-isolable reagent. Okay, let me learn their stereochemistry. If the carbon is a chiral, that time here we get the retention of configuration. Stereochemistry. Here the studies of the Curtius rearrangement of optically active acyl azide, in which the chiral carbon is directly bonded to the carbonyl group, have shown in this reaction, that is C6H5CH2 CH3COOH. This is our reactant. This is the chiral carbon over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then which is reacted with the first ClCOOC2H5, second that is sodium azide NaN3. On heating, there is a formation of what? Isocyanate. and further reaction with the water molecule, what will be the product? The product will be C6H5CH2CCH3HNH2. This is the product, and here this product gives a retention of configuration. Our today's assignment is predict the product with the mechanism. This is the first reactant, and here these are the number of reagent. All these reagent, you know very well, this is the reagent of what? Curtius Rearmament reaction. Both of these are Curtius Rearmament reaction, but you have to prepare the product, predict the product with a mechanism. You have to submit it today only. Thank you very much for watching this lecture. Comment it and also like this lecture. Thank you very much.